And so how new is this technology that you're using, and how widespread could it be used?
It's actually relatively new. We have got a significant funding from the Australian Cancer Research Foundation a couple of years ago, and we are now building up a kind of a network across the eastern seaboard with a specific focus on regional and rural Australia. So we have systems in place in Mount Isa, in Cairns, but then down to Wagga Wagga until Wontagi. So the idea is really to provide equity of access for people who have a high risk for melanoma.
And what have you learned from your research?
Yes, what we have learned, this is it's a very good question. What we have learned so far is that our the people who are using this our systems, basically our study participants, like very much this new approach. Basically, within a second, we are able to take an avatar of your total body, which is an unprecedented image quality, and which of course allows a beautiful documentation of your skin, and also for follow-up purposes. Because today, when we image you, your skin may be perfect, but then after 1 or 2 years, skin lesions, skin spot may change, and with the technology, we are very fantastically able to diagnose the change to basically realize the change of your skin.
And so how much earlier could it potentially detect melanoma than current methods?
Yeah, this is actually a very good question. To be honest, already now, Australian doctors are doing a fantastic job in detecting melanoma very, very early. But still, unfortunately, close to 2,000 people are dying every year on this tumor. And I think one of the ideas that our research should lead to a targeted nationwide screening program.
Do you think that this will be rolled out to clinicians or to more GPs, or will it stay in the hands of specialists when it gets to that point?
Yeah, this is actually a very good question. We think that basically in the future there will be probably standalone clinics will be part of existing clinics, of radiology sites. It's basically the imaging will be done in conjunction with a skin imaging technician who will conduct the 3D total body scans in the future and taking pressure off of a stretched medical workforce. But then the diagnosis will be done basically supported by artificial intelligence, so that the clinicians who will then provide the ultimate diagnosis may not necessarily be to be present in regional Australia. So the idea is to build up a telehealth network, which will basically change the way and lead to a paradigm shift in the way how the melanoma diagnosis will be done.
It could make a big difference to people's lives. Congratulations again, and thank you for joining me. That's Professor Peter Soyer from the University of Queensland.
Thank you so much, Fiona.